Yeah, so there are three main pathways that regulate aging in animals and probably in ourselves. There are the sirtuins that I've talked about a lot today. There's one called mTOR, which responds to how many amino acids are in your body. It will hunker down and protect the body the fewer amino acids it has access to.
Okay.
Okay, then the third is called AMPK, and this is the energy sensor. When your body has low levels of energy, it will allow the body to hunker down and protect itself from diseases. But why AMPK is worth mentioning is this is one of the targets, as we call it, of the drug metformin. Metformin okay. will activate this AMPK pathway and make the body think that it's hungry when often it's not, and also keep your blood sugar levels more steady at a cellular level.
Okay.
But it also has an interesting side effect is for a lot of people, myself included, it's a bit harsh on the stomach, so it also reduces my appetite. But what's great about metformin is that it's been in millions of people for a few decades. So we know the side effects. They're relatively low.
Sorry, really fast. So metformin is creating at a cellular level the sense that I'm hungry, and you're saying that from a hormesis perspective of a little bit of bad, it's like stressing the system, and that's why we think it works?
It is. It's exactly doing that. And so that it actually helps the body respond in a way to boost the energy supply. So one thing it does that's undeniable is it boosts the numbers of mitochondria.
It actually creates additional mitochondria. So your cells are getting more efficient or more able to generate energy?
Right, over the long run. But in the short run, what it does is it actually poisons part of the mitochondria. So it's a little bit of poison that leads to benefits down the line.
What part is poisoned?
It's called complex one. So that there are protons that are in one part of the area of the mitochondria in a membrane region, and the cell builds up protons. It becomes really acidic in that region, but the cell wants to release them. So what they do is they put little pores in between the membranes so that they can leak from the high concentrated zone to the low concentration in the middle. And as they pass through that pore, it spins the pore around, and that spinning, physical spinning of that protein will generate chemical energy called ATP.
That's how ATP is created.
And without ATP, we're dead in about 10 seconds.
Yeah. Okay. That's crazy interesting. And you're saying, sorry, to go back to the poison is elevating those levels, which is causing more to go through the pores?
It's actually decreasing ATP in the short run. Mm-hmm. So the cell says, man, I haven't got enough chemical energy in ATP.
So that's what forces it to create more mitochondria.
Right.
So that's the poisoning part.
It is.
So the increased number of mitochondria is in response to the slight poisoning.
Exactly. But there are two other important points. The cells in our body also think that they need to become more sensitive to insulin.
Yeah.
Which keeps our glucose and sugar levels more steady.
Okay.
Yeah. That's key because that's what helps the type 2 diabetics recover and, you know, prevents the disease from getting worse.
Yes.
And the second is that it's just been discovered in humans that if you take metformin, a lot of it, and exercise, it can blunt the effects of exercise on building mitochondria. What we think is going on is that you don't want to always have metformin in your system, or your body won't have a chance to recover from that slight poison. I'm not going to prescribe anything, I'm not a doctor, but we think it's better to take metformin on days that you're not exercising and recovering. And pulse it again, so you've got metformin, exercise.
Right. I know you're not prescribing anything, but how many days are you taking it? How many days are you not? How often are you exercising? How often are you not?
I actually spent a lot of my 30s and 40s not exercising at all. It's crazy, right? Someone like me. But I've become better at it now that I was approaching 50, now I'm 50. So I spend about 4 hours in the gym on the weekend with my son, Benjamin.